I'd like to do is I'd like to show you how to take your leather hard pinch pot and finish it. I just showed you how to create the pinch pot, and we let it dry overnight, and now we have a form which is leather hard. We know it's leather hard because it's cold to the touch, it's stiff, but yet it feels sort of like cheddar cheese does. That is a nice description of leather hard. Now what we're going to be doing is we're going to be cleaning it, we're going to be leveling the edge, we're going to be getting rid of any bumps or lumps that are in it, and we're just going to generally make it look nice and tidy. The first thing that I'd like to do is I'd like to level the edge. Now what I do is I usually put it on a turntable, and I like to tell my students I get down at eye level with it. When I look across, I want to be able to see the entire depth of the edge, and I'm going to be marking it at a level where I'm going to make sure that I cut off the lowest portion. So if I take something, I could take a knife, I could take a needle tool, I'm going to hold my hand steady and I'm going to put it on a turntable and I'm going to mark it. Now honestly, when I typically mark this, I usually am probably standing with my hand locked, say something like this. I might have my hand locked on my side, and I would probably have it pulled a little closer to me like this. So this is going to be kind of general. I'm fairly close on getting it somewhat level. What I'm going to do now is I'm just going to trim off some of this edge above the line. I do not want to cut on the line. I want to make sure that I'm cutting above the line. Now these scraps, which are leather hard that I'm trimming off, these I'm going to be setting aside, and I will recycle them, but because they are leather hard, I'm probably going to have to recycle them all together in the pug mill, which will take me a little bit more time. If it's plastic, usually you can just put it right in the pug mill and add a little bit of water. When it's leather hard, it takes a little longer to pug. Okay, now this is the part where you want to look and kind of visually inspect this by eye. Look for any taller areas that you might have and trim them down relatively even. Now you can use the Surform tool. In the Surform tool, I'm going to use just for the final touch to even it out. Okay, that looks pretty even. It doesn't look pretty from the top, but it does look nice and level. Okay, I get my debris off of there. You always want to watch it when you have debris, because if you set it in debris, you're going to end up by creating kind of a mess. Now, yesterday we did take a rib and we tried to smooth it as much as we could. Now today what I'm going to do is I'm just going to come along here, and any bumps or lumps that perhaps I missed, I'm going to fix those. This particular one, the bottom is not terribly even. This is not the same one that I did in the previous video. So I need to make sure that I get that bottom even and in the middle. I want it to look round and I want it to look in the middle. Okay, so as I do this, bring that off. Now I'm going to come along in here and I'm going to work on the upper edge. Now, one of the things that I have to look for on the upper edge is I want to make sure that my edge is going to look very, very round and very, very even. So if I start with the outside, I can then always take the inside and make it look even to match. Now, I have a couple different things that I could use on the inside. If it's not terribly bad, I could just quite simply use a metal rib and I could scrape away the clay. You can see how I'm beginning to scrape away some of the thickness there. If it's quite lumpy, you could use a Surform that is bent differently than the one that I already used. This Surform is bent end to end, but it's flat side to side. This Surform is bent side to side, so it enables you to get in a round, curved interior. So what I'm going to do right here is I'm going to take this and I'm going to thin this down just a little bit. And what I'm trying to look for is I am trying to look for a nice round edge and an even thickness wall. And even if your wall isn't thick, or the same thickness all the way down. A lot of it is going to be about illusion. What is the appearance when people look at it? Does it appear to be even? Does it appear to be thick? I'm also going to just take the Surform, and I'm going to knock off a little bit of the squareness of that edge. So I'm making the edge look a little less thick right there, so that you can see how it kind of became slightly rounded. Now that I have Surformed that, now I will come back in here, and I'm going to take my stainless steel scraper, and I'm going to scrape away some of the dents that I have from the Surform. Now, just like with the yellow rib yesterday, I need to continuously clean off the clay buildup that I get on the edge of the rib. And I'm going for something that should look relatively smooth. Now, this might take me a few minutes because I really am trying to look at everything. I'm trying to get a nice, even interior without dents or lumps. I want it to look smooth. So I'm going to work on the bottom, going to work on the sides, and work on those interior corners down in there. So I'll do this for a few minutes, and then I'll come back and show you what it looks like. Okay, so I have now cleaned the interior of this as much as I can with a combination of the metal rib and the yellow rib. These small ones are really terrific because they can really fit down in there and give you a nice little contour. If you use the large ribs, it might end up by leaving a lot of lines. One thing you do have to concentrate on is when you initially put the rib in there is you have to watch the angle at which you first make contact, because it would be easy to gouge. You have to watch that. Now, once you have cleaned it with the metal and the yellow ribs, then you can do the final cleaning with a red rib. Now, the red rib is the softest rib of all, and it is able to put some final finishing touches on it that perhaps you can't quite do with the yellow rib. Now, if you have any residual lines in there, just take your finger, run across them, and that can get rid of any last little rib marks that you might have. So the inside looks pretty good. Now we still need to address the outside, and we need to address the rim. I'm going to go ahead and do the outside right now. I'm going to finish any lumps that I still see, a couple of lumps right here. So I'm going to just take the Surform and make sure that it looks smooth and continuous. I want to watch out for anything where I might have a corner or a dent or a divot. And then I'm going to take the ribs, and I'm going to go across the outside in the same manner that I did the inside. I'm going to use the metal rib and the yellow rib both. So I'm going to go ahead and do this, and then I'll come back and show you what it looks like when I'm done. Okay, now I have cleaned the inside and the outside with both the stainless steel rib and then the yellow rib. Again, I could go over the outside a little bit more with the red rib just for some final smoothing, almost polishing. It helps you to really identify if you have any flaws in it. Now, the last thing that I need to do on the outside here is I need to work on the rim. because the rim is still a little bit messy, not quite uniform. It is level, and it is relatively even with thickness, and it should be round at this point. If it is not round, correct it and make it round. What I'm going to do next to finish this is a really simple trick. I have some plastic type cards that I have cut little notches in. There are notches of different sizes. I'm going to pick a notch that I think would make a good thickness for my rim, and this has to be leather hard for this. I'm going to hold the card and just steadily pull it along, and I'm going to thin my rim. Now, if you need to come back in here and thin it a little more in a place, like maybe it seems a little bit thick right there, I can take off a little bit more. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to keep on thinning this rim down. Not really making it lower so much as I'm just taking off a corner on the sides and making it skinnier. Okay, now that I've thinned the edge, I did end up by getting a little line here, so I need to come in here with my rib and I need to remove a little bit of the clay right there where it was maybe a little too thick, thicker than I wanted it to be at least. Okay, now we have a nice thinned rim. I have cleaned up the edge underneath it so I don't have any bulging lines where the rib created a funny little line. Now I do need to come in here and I need to make sure that when you look at it directly from up above, it looks perfectly round. If it has a corner or something, that imperfection needs to be fixed right away. Now, this still has one issue, and I have not discussed it yet, but you can see how it wobbles. The reason it is wobbling is because the bottom is not completely flat. It is slightly concave here, and I'm not really worried about that funny little spot either. What I'm going to do is I'm going to create an indentation in the middle right here that just goes in slightly. For that, I'm going to use one of the ribbon tools, and I'm going to carve away just a little bit of the bottom. It does not have to be deep at all, but what this is going to do is it's going to allow me to have a little concave area, so it takes any of the pressure where maybe the pot was sitting on the very, very middle bottom. It's going to take the pressure off of that, and instead it's going to sit on an outer foot ring. So I have a little concave area. Now when it sits, it does not rock. Okay, so this is now cleaned up and it's ready to start drying, or in the case of the Majolica, I do want to put on the underglaze. I mean, in case of the Sgraffito, I want to put the underglaze on before I let it dry. I am going to get my initials back on here since I would have cut them off, and you would put your bell on there. If you don't do the underglaze today, you would cover this up tightly with a bag, and you would return it to the board that you had it on initially. So I would put it back on the board. This one is not cleaned, but this is one that I made previously. The one which is cleaned, but you're not gonna do Sgraffito on, you will leave it uncovered so it can dry. We will put these in the drying cabinet and then I will get these fired. The other ones though, we're gonna keep them covered until we're ready to do the underglaze and then do the Sgraffito, which I will show you in a whole another video how to do the underglaze.